It was a fine day. Sun was up. A peaceful day as always. Everyone was working their normal life. Smiles on faces everywhere.
And then came a snap that changed the whole world. A catastrophe causing death all around the globe. Chaos occurring all around. People on the brink of death and even mass destruction. Planes crashing. The aftermath was even worse. Dead bodies everywhere. Building collapses and destroyed. People losing their homes and their family. Overflow in the hospital. Even tears rolling down cheeks everywhere. Electronic devices piled up and all ruined.
Looks like my job here is done. It's time to go back home.
She came, fulfilled her dream, and leaves with a joy in her face.
I'm sorry, boys. We could not save your father. His pacemaker could not function from the same destruction that affected the planet.
Tears rolled down for the two boys that just lost their father. But not only destruction happened from the snap for two new heroes that are newly born. These heroes are born to avenge the death of everyone around the world.
Hey brother, what is your progress on improving the pacemaker and ICD?
So now the pacemaker relies on complex microcircuitry that uses electromagnetic waves and contains metal, making it susceptible to interference from surrounding electromagnetic radiation. M is plotting a scheme to create electromagnetic havoc by aggregating electromagnetic radiation from multiple sources in hospitals, producing a much more pronounced and devastating damage.
From our research, patients with arrhythmia diseases like us will be affected. For generations, our whole family were using the pacemaker and the implantable cardioverter defibrillator or ICD. So the pacemaker is just like what you said just now. While ICD also can act like a pacemaker, but it also can defibrillate the heart if it senses dangerous rhythm.
Our target? Heart patients. The EMI effect might very likely cause the pacemaker to ignore the heart's own rhythm and deliver pulses irregularly at a fixed rate or stop them totally. It's silent death from the inside. No warning, no second chances. Heart stops, oxygen's out, bam, you're dead.
For me, I expect the DMI to generate signal in the range of 10 to 60 Hz. This frequency will overlap the cardiac signal range. It will usually cause interference in the cardiac devices like what we are using right now, the pacemaker and the ICD.
M is targeting the hospital, and I've analyzed the possible interference sources and we might be looking at radiotherapy, magnetic resonance imaging, ionizing radiation, but I predict EMI is targeting the MRI machine. Now, the MRI machine contains a powerful magnet and a strong static magnetic field resulting in synchronous pacing. The time-varying magnetic gradient field would produce induction voltage, and the radio frequency field would result in heating of the pacemaker.
So, how do you think we could encounter the MRI?
Two factors determine the degree of EMI: the distance from the EMI source and the duration of exposure. I say it results to mechanical and electrical shielding. We'll combine our powers to implant a virtual titanium casing over the pacemaker. We then go into interference rejection mode and create a signal filter around the pacemaker's receptor.
Yeah man, finally we just use our noise erosion superpower to revert Emmy's attack back to her and take her out of her own radiation.
After long, it's time for me to return. I am EMI, the strongest villain in the universe. Heard that there are two superheroes born from my destruction. Very well. Time for me to give them a warm welcome.
Hey, where are we? Why are we suddenly here? Hey, it's you again. You are the one who killed our parents 20 years ago. We are actually expecting for you to come back so that we can revenge.
Oh, I see. Indeed, it was me. Ha ha ha. And I am back. This time, it's your turn to test death. Ha 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 ha.
We were able to kill our parent 20 years ago. That is because our technology are limited. Today, we have improved our technology, and you will sure be defeated.
How ignorant can you be? Test my wrath!
What happened? Why is it not working? I guess I have to go on my full mode. Oh.
What are you doing? Nothing happened?
Talk, talk, talk. No more talk. This time we win. That's it.
I will be back.
So before we begin, hope you guys enjoyed the short film and don't miss the post-credit scene after this, yeah? So,
prepared for you.
So before going into the post-credit scene, we are here to talk about some things about EMC that haven't been mentioned in the video. So Devendra, how about you start with the definition?
Yes, okay. So let me start with the definition, which is EMC, which stands for electromagnetic compatibility, which is the branch of electrical engineering concerned with unitensional generation, propagation, and reception of electromagnetic energy, which may cause unwanted effects such as electromagnetic interference, EMI, or even physical damage in operational equipment. So EMC actually deals with problems of noise emission as well as noise immunity of electronic and electrical products and systems. So electromagnetic disturbance occur as conducted interference as well as radiated and immunity problems. So I'll move on to the history.
Let's know about history of EMC. Yes, how about history of EMC, Dave?
Yes, so the earliest EMC issue which actually came up was due to a lightning strike. It's a lightning electromagnetic pulse, or known as LEMP, on buildings. So these lightning rods or lightning conductors began to appear in this mid-18th century. So with the advent of widespread electricity generation and power supply lines from the late 19th century on, problems also arose with equipment's short circuit failure affecting the power supply and with local fire and shock hazard when the power lines were struck by lightning.
Oh, we can see this in the video, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's interesting. Right.
So let's just fast forward to World War II. So after the World War II, the military became increasingly concerned with the effects of nuclear electromagnetic pulse, NEMP, lightning strike, and even high-powered radar beams on vehicles and mobile equipment of all kinds, and especially aircraft electrical systems. So when high RF emission levels from other sources became a potential problem, certain frequency bands were designed for industrial, scientific, and medical use, allowing unlimited emissions. So we go on to the 1970s, where the popularity of modern digital circuit rapidly grew. As this technology grew, with faster switching speeds and lower circuit voltage, EMC increasingly became a source of concern. Many more nations became aware of EMC as a growing problem and issued directives to the manufacturers of digital electronic equipment, which set out the essential manufacturing requirements before their equipment could be marketed or sold. So we move on to the 1980s, where the ever-increasing use of mobile communications and broadcast media channels has put huge pressures on the available airspace. Regulatory authorities are squeezing band allocations closer and closer together, relying on increasingly sophisticated EMC control methods, especially in the digital communication area, to keep cross-channel interference to an acceptable level. So digital systems are inherently less susceptible than analog systems, and also offer far easier ways to implement high sophisticated protection measures. So even to the most recent events, even the ISM bands are being used for low power mobile digital communications such as Wi-Fi and remotely car door keys. This approach relies on intermittent nature of ISM interference and use of sophisticated error correction methods to ensure lossless reception during the quiet gaps between the bursts of interference. So I guess let's move on to the part.
Okay, that was a brief history for EMC, right? Okay, that's a brief definition and also history. So let's go into EMC standards and regulations. So for these, we have to go back into 1970s. Like Dave said, 1970s is the period where technologies are rapidly growing. And I can say around 1979, first EMC standards and legislation were introduced. The Federal Communication Commission, or known as FCC, right? Yeah, FCC in the USA, imposed legal limits on the electromagnetic emissions from all digital equipment. So one of the major elements of this was the EMC directory 89/336/EC. So this EMC directive from the EC was groundbreaking in terms of EMC standards and legislations, as it was the first time that limit has been placed on the immunity of the equipment to interference as well as its emissions. So it has grown so far, and it is having a lot of standards right now. So let's look into some of the standards that's been in the market right now. So one of the standards that is related to our video just now is in medical. So I can say the standard is IEC 60601-1-2, medical products. But other than that, there are also EMC standards like DO160 for aerospace, SAE ARP 5412B, SAE ARP 5416A, SAE J1113, all these are for aerospace. And also there are, SAE J1113 is for automotive. And other than that, there are also a lot of standards for commercial, medical and military, and also aerospace and such kind of that. Other than that, we can say that there are also laws have been implementing for this EMC. So one of the laws for this EMC is implemented in European countries, or I can say the countries that following European laws. The law is actually EU Directive 2004/108/EC, previously 89/336/EEC on EMC, defines the rules for the distribution of electric devices within the European Union. More are given the list of EMC directives. So these are the standards and laws that have been throughout this one that have been in the markets right now. Other than that, we know about appliances that have been using EMC in hospital. Like in the video, not only pacemaker, ECG, but also X-ray, CT scan, MRI scan. And EMC is also important because we are also using handphones in the hospitals, and EMC is very important in hospital because in hospitals it always involves lives, am I right, Dave? So it is very, you have to be very sharp about it. You have to be very detailed about it. So
it's a major concern, actually, EMC. You shouldn't take it lightly, actually.
Yes. So that's all from us, me, Divakaran, and also
Dave.
Okay, that's all from us. So hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let's go into
the post-credit scenes.
Yes, thank you.
EMI, the strongest villain ever exists in the universe. I have existed long before you, and I am here to wipe out half of the livings on Earth. Today, I'll start by wiping out the hospitals. Once I snap my fingers, I unleash my power. My power lies
specialize in electromagnetic interference, an electromagnetic energy that badly affects the performance of electrical and electronic equipment by creating unwanted disturbance. You won't like it because it affects your safety performance as well as your peace of mind. I can cause narrowband interference and intentional transmission, and usually involves a high frequency operation such as mobile phones and Wi-Fi router. Another interference that I can cause is broadband interference, which comes from incidental radio frequency transmitter. My power can be coupled, in other words, traveled radiatively, conductively, or through coupled coupling. My favorite will be radiative coupling. Even if there is a large distance between my target and me, I can still easily attack them. And you can see why it's my favorite method of power. Conductive and coupled coupling are less favorable because they require a medium. Over the years, I have attacked many places. In hospitals, I usually cause injuries to patients wearing ambulatory medical devices such as implantable pacemaker, as well as neurostimulators, interference by electromagnetic field emitting security systems such as anti-theft system and security metal detectors. When I am feeling merciful, I usually only cause mild injuries to patients. But when something infuriates me, I cause death among patients. I have to thank humans because with the rise of wireless technologies, you make it even easier for me to kill.